Sir, I wish to thank all the members for participating and all others who are present here without participating to support the bill, including Mr. Rajya. So I really wish to thank all of them for being here and providing moral support as well as oral support.
Rajya will always support.
So I wish to thank all of them for doing this. Sir, this budget essentially was trying to address some of the challenges that the members have mentioned. Sir, one is there's a growing demand from various sections of people. They need more trains, they need safe travels, they need better facilities, they need speed, they need different kinds of travel experiences, because somebody wants to go by super fast train, he is willing to pay more. Somebody wants to go by average speed but wants to pay less. So different kinds of challenges, different kind of expectations of railways. So to meet all of this, this budget essentially actually has been targeted. So if you are really looking at it, we are really trying to meet all these very conflicting and very different kinds of demand from the same organization. So this must be the only organization in the world which has to cater to such a diverse expectation, different expectations. So we are really trying to do that, and I am very happy to say that we are really trying to work on that. Sir, we had first one problem the railway has been facing, and I'll come to one very good point my good friend Mr. Raju Shukla has asked. But generally, sir, we have been facing one of the major challenges of railway is that it is a part of the government of India. It is not only like NTPC or NHPC, it's not a separate company. It's an integrated part as a department of government of India. At the same time, people expect it to be run as also a commercial enterprise. So this is actually a problem, like operating ratio, which you ask about the difference between total expenditure and total income. That is something we should be judged as one of the prime parameter by which whether this organization is working on commercial principles or not. At the same time, being part of the government of India, people expect that we should provide concessional travel, we should help people to travel as much as possible. So actually speaking, this is a major paradox that we want to run as a commercial organization, at the same time it should be part of the government of India and therefore must meet social obligation. So this is one of the major challenges the railway is facing, one. Secondly, the railway organization as such, the board, railway board, which has been there for a long time, working in different silos. But to deliver on the ground, we need everybody to come together. So this again is one of the challenges. There is engineering, there is mechanical, there is electrical, there is traffic, there is accounts. So we are trying to, in this year budget, we are trying to say that we are actually working on some 7 different missions. And that day, one person was asking question on Friday, I didn't hear him properly. We have actually set up the mission directors for each of these, and we are going to take these 7 missions of 25 tons, mission zero accident, mission pace, that is for procurement and consumption efficiency, mission Raftar for increasing speed in 16-17 as well as beyond, mission 100 sidings, which my good friend mentioned, as well as mission beyond bookkeeping to bring in accounting reform, as well as highest capacity utilization. So all of this has been one of the major principles when we have started working on it. Sir, many people wanted to know whether what has been the achievement. I will not go into many achievements, because first time in the railway's history, we have given action taken report on each of the points that was mentioned in 15-16 budget. So the 16-17 budget is actually giving the budget document. There is an annexure which gives 137 points on which you have taken action. But some silent feature, particularly about doubling, etc., people ask me. Sir, 15-16, we achieved doubling of 973 kilometers. New lines, 817 kilometers. 813 kilometers. Gauge conversion, 1042 kilometers, which aggregates to 2828 kilometers. Sir, this is the highest ever achieved, not only highest, but probably 15-16% more. Like, for example, on doubling projects, we spent in 14-15, 3,881 crores, 15-16 was 9,000 crores, 9,007 crores to be more precise, and 16-17, the budget, all of you are going to pass soon, 25,119 crores. So doubling amount has been increased from 3,881 crores to now 25,119 crores only in a matter of 2 years. Because this is what we need. And the doubling that you talked about, in whether there is a doubling in Assam or not, but first we must put single line, we must convert the lines, then we can think about doubling. But we actually have created a budget which is 250% more year on year for doubling. This is unprecedented, and that has been something like this. Same thing for electrification. You wanted to ask about electrification. Sir, in 14-15, the amount of money spent on electrification was 1,391 crores, which created a physical achievement of 1,375 kilometers. In 15-16, it has been increased to 2,265 crores, and the kilometer achieved is 1,600 kilometers. But in 16-17, we are targeting 3,396 crores with a target of 2,000 kilometers. Sir, in addition to this, we are working with the Ministry of Power so that we will not invest our own money, railways will not invest money. The Ministry of Power has a company which will invest money into electrification and will use the entire resources for electrifying the network as fast as possible. This will reduce the cost, this is good for the environment, this can increase the speed of trains. So therefore, this again is a target to increase electrification in a significant way. Madam, we are also working on setting up of a Shrestha, a dedicated organization for research and development. I know all of you will be agreeing that if we don't invest today in tomorrow's requirement, we'll be repenting little later. So we must have a research and development organization. We have created a Shrestha type of organization. And Dr. Saraswat, who is a member of DTI Aayog, we had a meeting with him only day before yesterday, and he's going to give us a report on Monday in the next 1 month, and then we'll try to take it forward. We are also creating railway planning and investment organization to take care of this various requirement, as well as organizational restructuring by merger of CADO, reorganization of railway board, and more importantly, why we could increase the speed. Because we delegated all the powers that the minister had for tendering, and these powers are now delegated to the general managers. So the general managers are able to take decisions, which otherwise used to take 2 years plus, is now brought down to less than 6 months. So this is something which has happened in this year, but the speed that will happen in the next few years will be even more than this. And I'll come to it later how it has resulted into more capital expenditure. Also, we are working on rationalization of tariff structure. Madam, sir, you will agree that many times the railways were charging so much that people moved away the traffic from railway to road. And we lost the money because two-thirds of the revenue of railways come from freight. So if you lose that revenue, railway will become a very serious financial crisis. So to ensure that, we reduce the peak season charge that we charge during this year, busy season charge, and therefore the traffic that hopefully will come to us little more. We also changed the project approval rules and many things. So I think in the next few years' time, we'll see a better result of whatever we are trying to do as a result of this. Madam, also in this year, the idea was, as I said, to improving the quality of travel. So we are actually introducing 5 new products. One is Antyodaya Express, which our Prime Minister believes in, that our entire government is working for the people, for that section of people who really needs our help. So we are starting Antyodaya Express, completely unreserved, but super fast service. Deen Dayalu coaches will be added, which many of you were asking, which will be adding to some of the busiest routes, so that this will be again the unreserved coaches with portable and higher number of mobile charging points. For reserved passenger, we are starting Humsafar, which is fully air-conditioned third AC service with an optional service for meals. So people can choose the type of meal they want. And Tejas, which will showcase, Mr. Raju Shukla was asking, will showcase the future of train travel in India. With this year, we already started Gatiman Express. The people who travel by Gatiman Express, there I got some very good feedback. Some saying, we don't believe it's a train and not a plane. Some people saying, it's a train, but don't think that it is in India. So these are the type of services that we are trying to offer also. From Varanasi to Delhi, we started a train, Mahamana Express, which again had a fantastic coaches, interiors were really good, and for common people. And then when the first photographs appeared on the social media, people thought it is not an Indian train, it must be foreign train. But it is actually working and it's being flying today. So we are trying to do that. The Tejas will actually work like this. We'll offer onboard service such as entertainment, local cuisine, Wi-Fi, etc. and one service provider to ensure accountability and improved customer satisfaction. Humsafar and Tejas will work on cost recovery basis, because somewhere those who can afford to pay must pay more. Those who are really one of our common people, the railways will take care of them. So Uday is an overnight double decker express which will be more capacity of almost 40% more. So you can leave at night, reach in the morning, and that is why we are trying to do that. And therefore these are the 4 different kinds of products we are trying to do. Madam, as I was saying, that the infrastructure investment in the railways in this particular 2 years has gone up considerably. It was 14-15, 48,700 crores. In the previous year, it was less than 40,000 crores. And 15-16, it has gone to 94,000 crores, and it will be further increased to 1,31,000 crores in 16-17. In next 3 years, we are going to increase the speed of commissioning of railway lines to about 19 kilometers per day from the present level of 7.7 kilometers per day. Augmentation of network capacity will actually result into investment of about 4 to 5 lakh crores in next 3 years' time. Sir, you will be happy to know the economy will benefit immensely. How much will be the demand for sleepers, cement, steel, cables, wagon will be exponential. Just to give an example, rails alone will be something like 20,000 crores. Sleepers, 6,500 crores. Cement, 6,000 crores. Signaling, 24,000 crores. Management of steel will be 10,000 crores. Wagon locomotive, 70,000 crores. So just imagine the impact of this increased capital expenditure on economy also. Not only in terms of augmenting capacity, helping people, but will also result into a huge benefit to the people at large, people of economy, and therefore we are very happy that we are working on it. I know some of my members, like my good friend from Assam, were just now saying that why don't you increase the expenditure on various states. So I'll just come to it in a minute. But I want to just tell you that in the last few years' time, it is not a comparison, not to blame anybody, but because you mentioned UPA, etc. I just want to tell you that in 14, if you take the average of expenditure on railways during UPA 1 and UPA 2, was 9,291 crores. And if you take now, it is 32,587 crores in the last 2.5 years, or including 16-17. So you can imagine whether we are doing something which is more than expectation or not, you can actually might as well do it. Average kilometers that were done during UPA 1 was 1,477 kilometers. UPA 2 was 1,520 kilometers. Now it has become 2,292 kilometers. And as just mentioned, the speed which is going to increase would mean that we'll actually be able to do even more than this. And therefore, I feel that we must work together to increase the expenditure, to increase the capital expenditure, and to bring more and more projects implemented. To do this, we are already working on various measures. One was delegation, bring complete transparency. All the work contacts, we want to put it on e-tendering platform. We want to make sure that everything will be available on e-tendering. And also, we are also working through public sector undertaking. Because as you know, to increase capital expenditure to such a level, it is not possible that the railway's present organization will be able to do it. So we are asking some of the special organization of railways to actually implement the projects, and therefore this again will result into more and more capital expenditure being incurred over a period of time. And therefore I am sure that in the course of next few years you will see even a better job. In ROBs and RUBs, some of the members asked, in earlier we used to spend in the last 5 years 762 crores per year. Last year we increased it to 1,024 crores. So again ROBs and RUBs also are trying to be increased in a very substantial way. I know that all of this is something which will really bring in a completely different kind of railways in the next 10 years' time. But to make that, we really need to work as in a sustained manner, as part of a plan, and therefore we are working on it. I just mentioned about increasing in the last 65 days, since the budget has been presented this year, we are trying to work on all the points that you mentioned on freight business. They have actually been implemented. We have already implemented about passenger business. 6 different announcements which are made in the budget have been implemented. 6 budget announcements on traffic implemented. On others, we have already worked on, including Gatiman Express, mobility of non-fare revenue directed, etc. We have already set up. So you can see that we really mean business, want to work in a manner that will actually bring in the change in the railways, which all of us want as a country should develop. Sir, you wanted to know about the various allocation to state. Sir, if you permit me, just I'll read please, out all the states.
Please.
Sir, in Andhra Pradesh, the amount of money in 2013-14 was 1,024 crores. In the last year, it has become more than double, and now, that time Andhra Pradesh was undivided. Now, I am talking about Andhra as well as Telangana separately. But it has become 2,659 last year, 2,823 crore this year. In Assam and Northeast, something that you are really interested in 13-14, the amount was 2,330 crores. 2,330 crores. In 14-15, 5,241 crores. In 15-16, 5,368 crores. And this year again, 5,340 crores. So you can imagine how much has been the increase for the Northeast as well as the Assam is concerned. In case of Bihar, it was 1,244 crores. We increased it to last year 2,489 crores and this year 3,171 crores. In case of Chhattisgarh, it was 379.8 crores in 13-14, the last year of the UPA2. We increased it to 464 crores last year, 1,304 crores in 14-15-16, and 1,738 crores in 16-17. In case of Delhi, Gujarat, it was 721.8 crores. It has gone to 3,530 crores. Himachal Pradesh, 56 crores in 2013-14. It has gone up to 310 crores in last year, in this current year. Jammu and Kashmir, 1,044 crores. It has gone to last year 1,643. This year it is 2,061.8 crores. Jharkhand, it was 654.2 crores. Last year was 1,894 crores. This year 2,235 crores. Karnataka, 909 crores, 13-14 last year of UPA, gone up to 1,315 last year, 2,496, 15-16, and 2,779 crores in this current year. Kerala, which was 265 crores in 13-14, last year was 324 crores, last 15-16, 1,098 crores, and now 1,041 crores. And I'm telling you, the Chief Minister of Kerala came with his cabinet and also senior MPs, I don't know whether you are there, and he told me whatever he discussed, we are trying to implement all of that in spirit of it. Madhya Pradesh, it was 748.9 crores, 13-14, 3,561 crores last year, and 4,325 crores for 16-17. Odisha, my good friend is very concerned, 812 crores in 13-14. 1,465 crore, 14-15, 3,712 crores, 15-16, 4,682 crores in 16-17. Now tell me, I should reduce it or what should I do? Punjab.
Just also said,
Punjab.
Highest revenue is given, at least said, that highest revenue railway gets from Odisha. 10% of the total revenue.
But that they were giving even earlier, no?
No, no. You will give it now, you are giving more.
I know.
Please say that on record.
Punjab, no.
The whole country should know, the house should know. But I
that's
think
why,
that is okay, why I okay, thank okay. you very much.
All right, all right.
Punjab,
all right, all right.
Punjab 236.9 crores, 141 crores in 15-16, 14-15, 823 crores in 15-16, 1,114 crores in 16-17. Rajasthan, 585.7 crores in 13-14, 542 crores to 2,511 crores and now 2,802 crores. Tamil Nadu, 922 crores, which has gone to 2,042 crores 15-16 and 2,064 crores in 16-17. Telangana, which obviously didn't have comparison because that didn't exist, has gone up from 755 as well as 790 crores. UP, this is very important. It was, I know, even my good friend will be interested to know about UP. It was 1,034 crores in 13-14. It went to 4,516 crores in 15-16. And now this year, 4,923 crores. So you must also thank my colleague, the Minister of State, also for it. Uttarakhand, to 240 crores, went to 450 crores, and this year, 458 crores. And West Bengal, my good friend Derek is not here, but 1,604 crores, 3,793 crores last year, and 3,820 crores this year. Why I'm telling you this is this has been given to all the states to ensure that we take care of all the country at the same time. Railways belong to India, and railways must also take care of India. And therefore, we must ensure that all the different states must get a proper aid. Madam, sir, sorry. Northeastern region has been something which my friends wanted to know. And I'm also interested to tell. Sir, if you permit me, only 2-3 minutes, because many members ask about it. This year, we introduced direct train connecting Itanagar to national capital in February 2015. Meghalaya saw the first broad gauge line with introduction of passenger train in November 2014. We also started gauge conversion project Rangia Murkong Selek of 510 kilometers race, and which has connected north bank of Brahmaputra on broad gauge. Lumding Silchar has been converted in November 2015. Barak Valley was bought on broad gauge network. With conversion of Badarpur, Kumarghat, Agartala meter gauge line into broad gauge, the Agartala, the capital of Tripura, has been brought on the broad gauge on 20th February 2016. We also brought Mizoram and Manipur on the broad gauge with the commissioning of newly converted Kathakal, Bhairabi and Arunachal Jiribam broad gauge line. In 16-17, entire railway track in northeastern region shall be broad gauge, as we plan to wipe out the remaining meter gauge by converting into broad gauge. In 16-17, we'll also see the fast tracking of Dimapur, Kohima, Bhairabi, Sairang new line, and therefore I am very sure that in 15-16, 16-17, we'll take up the complete work in the next 2-3 years time. So I don't know where you got this statement. I never said, so probably you read somewhere wrongly that I must have said that we are converting everything. We never said we are not going to bring it because of the hilly region. We want to make sure we do it. And in case of Meghalaya, you'll be very happy to say that two projects in progress will provide little Meghalaya. With Tetalia Bairniat new line, Bairniat Shillong new line, and total outlay for this project is 510 crores. So all of these are in the pink book. So if you look at the budget statement, where you read the only budget speech, probably you may not find it. The real capital expenditure is mentioned in the pink book. In fact, same thing happened. If you announce a coach factory, it is very easy to mention in the budget speech that we'll do this, we'll do this. It is like a preamble to the constitution. But if no provision in the constitution will not apply. The same thing, if it is not in the pink book, nothing will apply. So that is what had happened, unfortunately. But we believe that rather than making a statement in the budget speech, please, I'll do it later. If rather than making a statement in the budget speech, we'll actually make sure that a provision is made in the budget, that is in the pink book. So you will find it, all of these, what I mentioned you, is actually provided in the budget so that this can be implemented in the proper manner. I know the concern of all of you that we must have everything for the common man. I don't want to take your time, but all of this, large number of this budget essentially is for the common man, for the weaker section, because that is a priority of our government. So therefore, if you find there are many, many provisions here, which I think, if you permit, sir, I will lay down on the table, yes, rather than reading it.
Yeah,
the recruitment of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, which is a very important issue. I am very happy to say, in 2008, there were 8,146 backlog vacancies identified for filling up. And now I am very happy to say that 99.55% of these vacancies have been completely wiped out. So more or less, we have taken care of all this of it, and therefore we should do it. The speed of the train, which is a very important issue. Sir, as I told you, we have already created a separate mission. We are trying to do many things. Gatiman is one part. The Tez Raftar train will be the other one. But also, there is an experimental basis. I don't know how far it will succeed. There is a Spanish company called Talgo. They are bringing the train which will run on the existing track, which might reduce the travel time between Mumbai to Delhi by as much as 5 hours. And therefore, if that happens successfully, we'll be able to actually the shortest time without least of capital expenditure, because no tracks are involved, we'll be able to actually manage this also in a significant way. So speed is one of the very important issues. We are trying to work on it. As I told you about the Kashmir also, that we are taking care of that. I know Raju wanted to ask about operating ratio, which is a fact. Sir, the challenge is, this year, we had a big problem. Pay commission liability. Bonus Act was amended by all of us. That increased the liability of the railways, railway being the largest employer. And therefore, despite that, we are able to work on a modest operating ratio, not deteriorated than the previous years, but obviously under stress, we are working on it. And therefore, we are working on many things, including creating a national plan for railways, which will be, because today what happens is, if you make a demand, I said, okay, I will do it. If he makes a demand, I said, I will do it. So as a result of which, we don't have an overall big picture of how the railway network should look at. So we are consulting all the stakeholders. including honorable members of parliament, state governments, other public people, I'll just pardon me. Public representative and their. So we are trying to work on that. We are also. Then we are also working on environment directed. We have created new energy policy for water. Today only we signed an agreement with the Honorable Minister of Environment and Forest that we are going to plant trees on railway line. And we have signed an agreement involving state governments also. So we'll take this forward. We are also working on employees who are one of the most important backbone of railways. I must put on record their sincere, dedicated, honest work has resulted into railways running despite all the odds. We have decided to start for the loco pilots who are at the cutting edge. A toilet, that was something which was inhuman, not to have a toilet for a loco pilot who is going to drive for 15, 16 hours.
So
and therefore, we are starting a loco pilot toilet in his cabin itself. We are also trying to make air conditioning. We are trying to give new uniforms to our people. Trackmen, who are another very important segment, like trackmen, loco pilots, station masters, all of them, we are trying to take care of them. And also MPs have contributed significantly. I must put on the record a generous contribution of my good friend, Honorable Mr. Tarun Vijay, of 2 crores for station development. I know all of you agree, then all the members can give only 5 crores each. We'll be able to develop railways even in a much better way. So I request you. For food, people are really expecting this, right? We are doing many things for food. One, that today the contracting system, we want to abolish. We want to give back the cooking part of that to IRCTC. They'll cook the food in a very sophisticated, mechanized kitchens, which will be therefore, which will sense human touch, and only the contractor job will be to deliver it. So we'll be able to control the quality better. In addition to this, we are also saying that e-catering will be started in most of the stations. So whatever food you want to order, Mr. Rajya will be interested in having curd rice. He can get a curd rice of his choice in the train. Our good friend, Mr. Ray, wants to have the food of Bengali sweets. He can get the Bengali sweets also ordered. So whatever is the e-catering, we'll be able to do that. And therefore, we are working on it. Drinking water, one of the very important points you mentioned. It is fact. Why should we not provide free drinking water? So we actually do it. But now we are working on a completely different quality check. So all the places where the drinking water dispensed, they'll be examined by the doctors also. The quality checks will be carried out so people get free water. In addition to that, we have started water dispensers at stations. So rather than buying a rail neer for 15 rupees plus, you can get the same quantity for less than half the price. You go there, fill it up, chilled water, RO clean water in a glass, and therefore you can drink it. So this is another thing we have started doing it, and therefore we are actually working on it. For Kalahandi,
Kalahandi
is something, as I told you, this was only mentioned in the budget speech, but I met the Honorable Chief Minister. And we said, we want to find out a solution to this. So the Chief Secretary of Odisha, our General Manager, are working on what kind of manufacturing we can start in Kalahandi. It's a very important issue, so we'll deal with that. You said, so many ministers went to Assam. For what? We don't know. So firstly, I'll just tell you, first time in railway history, the Railway Week last year was organizing in Assam. One of the major events, all the people came from it. This year we organized it in Odisha. So this is the priority we have, where we should do it, where it has never been organized. It normally would be organized in my state or his state. But we said, no, we'll organize in place where we really need to do it. Stoppages is something which I know is a problem, because more the stoppages, more the delays, the speed goes down. So therefore, we must have a proper balance between stoppages, which is the convenience, as well as the overall speed of the railway, which it has to be a priority. We are working with the state governments. I'm very happy to say that all the state governments, 16 of them, have agreed to make partnership with us. We are very happy the way states are cooperating, including Odisha. And I met the Chief Minister again recently and reviewed it. Sir, this is going to be a game changer. Railways have been very, very centralized organization working only from Delhi. The action is in the state, not only state capital, even below that. So unless you make them as partners, unless you work in the spirit of cooperative federalism, which our Prime Minister so well articulates, we will not be able to do what we want to do. Therefore, we are working on it. And therefore, I am very happy that you have given all the suggestions. I will not respond to individual suggestions because they are very important. We will take care of them and we will try to take them forward. I wish to thank all the honorable members for participating into this. And therefore, we will like to take it. You know, my good friend, I'll just finish.
Railway station.
Improve the Kamakhya
railway station. Will you able to include the Kamakhya railway station within the 18 or 19? You have already taken the 18 railway station for the beautification.
See, there are.
और लगभग हम सभी लोग ट्रेन से आते हैं, दिल्ली में उतरते हैं। मेरी आपसे एक रिक्वेस्ट है कि अपने सीनियर ऑफिसर्स को, या चाहे आप खुद भी चलिए वहाँ जाके देखिए, वहाँ तो ठगों का साम्राज्य है। जो नई दिल्ली रेलवे स्टेशन का जो चेहरा है, जो सर्कुलेटिंग एरिया है, इतनी अव्यवस्था है, 1 लाख से ज़्यादा आदमी वहाँ रोज ट्रैवल कर रहे हैं। लेकिन आप कभी जाके देख लीजिए, इट इज डेंजरस टू वॉक थ्रू दैट स्पेस। प्लीज डू समथिंग ऑन दैट।
ओके ओके,
यही
Honorable Minister, are you aware that the new train introduced from Delhi to Silchar, Barak Valley of Assam, Sampak Kranti, this new train very recently in the month of August, this was last month of August, this was launched, but so far 8 numbers of times it was derailed. There was derailment for 8 times. So what is the technical defect? What is the technical defect? I want to know from you, sir.
Chief.
Sir, Assam, sir, Assam और नॉर्थ ईस्ट में, असम और नॉर्थ ईस्ट में डबल लाइन ट्रैक का काम कब से शुरू होगा सर? डबल लाइन ट्रैक का काम सर कब से शुरू होगा, ये मैं सर जल्द जानना चाहता हूँ।
सर,
he yielded. I didn't ask, only he yielded.
One point.
Good by saying that we have. One point. As everybody wanted to know, the strategy for speed, as I said, is one is a high speed train, which is the first time it is coming to India, which will run between Mumbai and Ahmedabad in by 2023. And I am very happy that you are supporting this idea by saying why only Mumbai, Ahmedabad, why not here? So I know Mr. Pramod Tiwari will be very happy to see that the party is also supporting this idea. So it's a very good thing. We'll all work together and work on this high speed train as well. But not just high speed train, as I was mentioning. Between that train, not all trains can work at 300 kilometers plus. We need trains which will run between 100 to 200, 200 to 300. So all the new products that we are talking about will bring in the speed improvement, as well as one of the reasons why there are delays in train today is because of huge train capacity between particularly on Delhi to Calcutta route, from where UP, Bihar, all the major popular state passengers travel, working at 150% of the capacity, which we are not augmented to our own peril. Now we are trying to do that. You will see a significant improvement as we go along, but definitely in 3 to 4 years' time, you will see a significant drop into the delays. Probably we'll be able to run a timetable train by then for goods train. We'll be able to improve the speed. We'll actually be able to make that. For the station, you mentioned about the huge traffic on the station. Why is it so? The station has remained the same. Number of people have increased manifold. What else you expect? And therefore, we are planning what you are asking me, my good friend Rani, who is a maiden budget speech, so I welcome it. So what she was asking was, how do you develop station? So there are many strategies. One is to convert the existing station by adding customer amenities. But transformative change is necessary. That's why we are developing 400 stations, which will be through a PPP model. It's a very complex model development anywhere in the world, largest program also. So we have worked on many things. The first contract has been awarded for Habibganj in Bhopal. We'll actually award more stations in the next few years' time. I will assure you, when that is done, you'll be very happy to see that railway stations will be different than what they are looking today. But I know this is unfortunate, that we are carrying a legacy which we need to change, but it will be possible over a period of time. So I really once again thank each one of you. I am very sure that keep all of you keep meeting me all the time, so I'll be available for meeting. Okay, tender also.
Delhi करने के लिए समता एक्सप्रेस दिल्ली संतरा एक समता एक्सप्रेस दिल्ली करने के लिए समता एक्सप्रेस को दिल्ली करने के लिए गोड़ा जी ने लिखा था, अभी तक नहीं हुआ समता को. और एक पॉलिसी मैटर सर, policy matter that all district,
you write to him,
all district as a,
you please write to him,
train should stop,
you please district write to him, he will give a reply.
the whole country.
No.
All district Bhupen, train should stop you as a policy matter.
You please write to me, we will send you a reply. Okay, now, question is that appropriation railways number 2 bill 2016, as passed by Lok Sabha, be taken into consideration. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have it. Motion is adopted. We shall now take up clause by clause consideration of the bill. Clauses 2, 3 and schedule stand part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have it. Clauses 2, 3 and schedule are adopted. Clause 1, the enacting formula and the title stand part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have it. Clause 1, the enacting formula and the title are adopted. Sri Suresh Prabhu to move that the bill be returned.
Sir, I beg to move that the bill be returned.
Motion moved that the bill be returned. The question is that the bill be returned. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have it. The bill is returned. Now, special